up, you guys? Welcome to Dreamland. It is I, the Dream King, Dream Doll, back again for another video. And I know it has been like a week, almost 2 weeks. Now, if this is your first time watching my channel, go ahead and hit that subscribe button and give me a big, big thumbs up because it'll really help me out. And I know that you will like this video, duh, because I'm like too cute today. Before I even get off into the subject, let's just talk about this look today. I don't know exactly what made me do this, but I am like digging it. I'm not sure what made me do it. I like it, and I think I look a lot better. It's, I don't know. I might have to do a get ready with me. I don't know. Comment down below, get ready with me, if you think I should do a get ready with me with this look, because I did do some new things and this came out beautiful. But anyway, we're gonna get on with the story because this is my second attempt recording this video because it's been so long since I recorded. I forgot that I had like light boxes. And yeah, so I tried to record this video without light boxes, with just my ring light. And yeah, it was really, really dark. And this right here was just, So we're gonna get on with the video. No, I did not do a vlog like I promised, but I did record bits and pieces of different parts, mainly with my boyfriend. But let's just get on with the video. So it's my birthday. I know it don't seem excited, but it's like so early in the morning. Man, say hey.
What up?
You ain't gotta do all this. Black people, you can't give black people a camera. So it's my birthday. I turned 22 and I want to go out of town because last year I only went like 30 minutes away. This year I went 2 hours away to where everybody loves going. Like everybody from my county and the surrounding counties always go to this place. Like it's beautiful there. I love it. It's Murfreesboro, Tennessee. Originally we were supposed to go to Nashville, but we couldn't find anything in Nashville. Everything was dumb expensive. And we was like, nah, bitch, we on a budget. We got his cousin, who's a travel agent, to book us a room. She booked us a room in Lebanon, which is like 30 minutes away, something like that. So I don't know how we missed the exit. I don't know if we was just talking too much or we was arguing. But not arguing, but like bickering, I guess. We missed the exit, which took us all the way through Nashville. Because I want to tell y'all about our journey here. Stop it. So, initially, we thought, did you just throw something on me?
It's raining.
We thought that our hotel was in Lebanon, Tennessee, wherever the fuck that might be. So, we thought the hotel was in Lebanon. We get there, it's nice, but we didn't have reservations there because that wasn't our hotel. So, before that, we passed the exit. Good morning. Before that, we passed the exit because he was running his mouth. And extended our trip for extra 5 hours. And it was only supposed to be a what, 2 hour drive? It was supposed to be a 2 hour drive. So we drove around 7 hours. We left out We left out maybe 12 o'clock. 12:30-ish, maybe 1 o'clock, and we didn't find a hotel until 7. Don't get mad because I'm telling the story. So we didn't find a hotel until 7. But once I saw that we was gonna go all the way through Nashville, bitch, I was like, no, not gonna happen because I'm scared of Nashville traffic. We stopped to get. We didn't get gas. I stopped to use the bathroom and he got in the driver's seat and, you know, drove us through Nashville. So, long story short, we get to Lebanon and we get to the hotel, nice hotel. We go in to do our reservations and get our shit out of the damn car because we just tired at this point. And she tells us that she don't see our name anywhere on there. So, he called his cousin and she was like, no, the reservations is in Gallatin. And we was like, really? But it was only 30 minutes away. That wasn't too bad. So we get to Gallatin, bitch. When we pulled up to that damn hotel, when we pulled up to that damn hotel, we was like, something ain't right. But let me back it up a little bit. We get to the hotel where we really got reservations for, and the shit is chewed the fuck up. Walk up to the window, holes in the blinds, bugs on the windowsill. And we was like, what the fuck? And they was owned by Indians. They couldn't talk. Bunch of Indians. I'm sorry if I got any subscribers. It's in my pocket. I'm sorry if I got any subscribers. It's like Indian. But they were Indian and we couldn't understand shit they were saying. And we was like, no. We didn't book that. His cousin did. So thank you, cousin. But she did do her job. So anyway, we drove around an extra hour and a half before we even found a hotel. We get to this one. It's gonna have to work. I like it. The inside is nice. This hotel had paint chipped off everywhere. We walk up to a window. It's Molly. The curtains got holes in them. Bugs on the windowsill. The people that owned it were Indians. They did not speak English. This was definitely a hole in the wall what we was avoiding. So he called his cousin and he was like, you wrong for putting us in this hotel, for booking this hotel for us. You know we did not want a hole in the wall, and this is exactly what it is. This is what we didn't want. So we pulled across the street because we was finna go through and like a hotel hunt like right quick. He went in to Burger King, got these nasty ass Kool-Aid slushies, and that's what we had while we, you know, looked for hotels. So we found one in Murfreesboro, Tennessee. We was like, well, that's 30 minutes away from Nashville. That's actually closer, and that's where everybody go. So we go to it's like a Motel 6, and we didn't want to go there, but we was out of options at that point. And across, we get there, we was like, this shit looked like the one in Gallatin. So we saw across the street, it was a Super 8. So he's like, now, I don't know about Super 8 either, but it looked good. And the inside looked even better. Had a little pool, not that big, but nonetheless, it was a pool. So we got that hotel, we finally got booked. It was cheaper. We get in the room, we get settled. And we decided we was hungry. So we go to TGI Friday, come back, chill. The next day, which was Saturday, we get up, we excited. We going to the zoo.
What zoo you trying to go to?
It's in Nashville.
It's 3 or 4 zoos in Nashville.
I'm not a pen zoo. A regular zoo. He's so irritating.
You want to see cats and dogs?
I don't want to see. I can go home.
Nashville
and
Zoo at Grassmere?
That's it. So,
it's 25 minutes away. 30 minutes away.
Yeah. Oh, but yeah, I know it don't look excited. I had to start on my festivities.
Who went to the zoo first?
I'm going to the zoo first. Cause by the time we get back from the zoo, Ray will be on his way. Then I can get in the pool.
Tell him bring some swimming trunks.
I already did.
He come. He gonna get in. We need to go look at this pool. We look like shit. I'm most definitely, you and Ray gonna be in that bitch by yourself. I'm gonna be out there taking pictures for you.
Shut up. Let me record with this video.
What the fuck, I'm getting a pool so I don't watch and shit and come
so,
out.
So, okay, I know I don't seem excited, but, are you losing me? Look, hold on, just.
I look ugly,
sweat.
Take that down.
I'm not taking you out of it. We're going to the zoo, right? So, we're going to the zoo. I try to film some of that and put it into my vlog, but yeah, I be doing shit all day. My best friend is coming down here and I can't wait, so I guess I will see y'all when I'm getting ready or when we leave. We so excited about the zoo, I even recorded a little clip before we even got in the zoo and we took pictures. So we made it to the zoo, right? But I said I was gonna vlog, but I don't think I'm gonna vlog because I already did a zoo vlog in Memphis. This one is a little different, but I just don't see the point of having two zoo vlogs. If it's anything interesting, when I come back another time, I'll do it, but I just don't think that I need to do it. And I just don't feel like vlogging it, so
Yeah.
So we dead excited about getting in the zoo. And I was like, you know what? I think I am going to vlog this. But you know what? I quickly stopped. Because not only did they not have anything but fucking birds and a few animals, bitch. That zoo was huge with absolutely nothing in it. No gorillas, no orangutans. They didn't have a giraffe. Well, they did have giraffes. But they were so far off, you couldn't see them. They had four rhinos. They was lazy as fuck. No hippos, no elephants, no ostriches, no bears, no lions, no tigers, no leopards, no pandas, no snakes. They had like a few snakes. Let me take that back. They had two big aquariums with like eight fish in it. Like, it sucked all the way through. And only thing that I enjoyed was taking pictures with a fucking kangaroo. That's the only thing. That was the highlight of that. So that was $16 wasted, went down a drain. It was just total bullshit. We was pissed. I want my money back. If y'all watch this video, Nashville Zoo, if y'all want y'all money back, y'all need to send me my money. Hit me up on my email. My email is below, bitch. I want my money back because I was completely unsatisfied for my birthday, ho. So we leave the zoo, whatever, disappointed or whatever, with our lips long into the floor. We have to get home, take baths. I wanted to get in the pool, so I got in the pool. My best friend was coming later on. We get in the pool, swim around. We took pictures in the pool. Get out the pool. By now, my best friend's like maybe like an hour, 30 minutes away. So we sit in the room, chilling or whatever before my best friend got there. And by the time he get there, we need to start getting ready to go to the club. They wanted to do a Walmart run, so we did a Walmart run, came back, get ready. I insert my little photo shoots and shit that I took in the room before we left.
My anaconda don't, my anaconda don't, my anaconda don't want none unless you got buns, hun.
My boyfriend was like, we're gonna go to Limelight. That's the club I went to when I was here. And I was like, is that a gay club? He was like, it's a straight club. He was like, what the fuck are we gonna do at a straight club? So of course we was against it, and we found a club in Nashville that was called Club Play. We get there, line long as hell, totally unsafe to cross the street. $5 to pay parking. That got me already. I don't pay for parking, no ma'am. So we get there, we have to pay for parking, and the line is like really long, but it moved quick. So we get in the club, and we immediately go to the side that's playing like the music. We get over there, we vibing, we go sit down, walk around, get a drink, and we want to see the shows, because they had drag shows on the other side. So we go to the other side, and we watch drag shows. So I'm all up on my boyfriend because I don't want nobody trying to holler at me. I'm taking. So we go back, find my best friend. We go sit down on the couch. Now, somewhere in between, why am I talking so fast? Somewhere in between me being on the phone and leaning on him, I put my keys down. It wasn't until I got to the next bar, which was like next door, that I realized that my keys were gone. So I'm like, okay, maybe somebody done left them, nobody saw them. Remind you, I got a big ball that you put on your purse on my keys. And my name is on my keys. Get over there, my keys are gone. This Philippine man talk hooder than me. He was probably the most urban Philippine man I have ever heard. And he had a smoker's voice. Like, his voice was so raspy, but he sounded like a straight up nigga. He was like, you looking for some keys? And I'm like, I ain't even started digging in the couch for no keys yet, but yeah. He was like, that dude right there in the black shirt, he got your keys. I walk up to the dude, he ain't got no keys in my hand. So I was like, why did he say he had the keys if he ain't got the keys? So I go to the DJ, and DJ was like, you know, like I take that back. I went to the bartender first. He was like, ain't nobody turn the keys in. Went to the DJ. I was like, can you announce that if somebody finds any black keys with a black ball on it, bring them to me? He was like, well, I told him to take them to the front desk. Go to the front desk, no keys. Now I'm panicking. So my boyfriend was like, how did you lose your keys? I told him, he was like, well, let me go make sure that ain't nobody took your car. Thankfully, nobody bothered the car. My car was still there. We go back, walking back and forth, walking around. Now I'm standing in one spot because I'm panicking and losing my fucking mind. So we go back to the guy. He was like, well, I tried to help you find him. He said, I'm going to try to help you. He's like, let me see if I see him anywhere. So I go back to the other side to go look. My best friend was like, I'm finna go look around and see if I find somebody with this black ball that ain't hanging. So he walked around. I'm still standing there looking stupid. My boyfriend texted me. He was like, have you found the keys? I was like, no, I have not, and I'm losing my shit. He texted me back 5 minutes later and was like,
I got the keys. Let's go now.
So I was like, okay. So we get outside. My best friend was like, I found somebody with a black ball, but they won your keys. Now, I ain't tell y'all how he found my keys. My key, whoever got the keys, took my ball off, kept it, and threw my keys behind the couch. He saw my keys sticking out of the curtains that was behind the couch. So that's how he got them. So he get the keys, and my best friend was like, I walked up on a girl with your ball. And she said it was hers. I said, I wish I had been with you. I would have checked it because I had a nigga rig because I had broke it about a month earlier. So I would have known it was my keys had, I had a went with him, but I was just like in panic mode. And I was ready to get out of there. My boyfriend was irritated. I was irritated. My best friend, he was fine. Ray, he was unbothered at all. He was just glad we got the keys, and it could have been so much worse. But my anxiety would not let me live to save my life. I was mad. I was frustrated. I wasn't frustrated with my boyfriend, but I think he felt like I was because I wouldn't talk to him. And I was going to sleep, and he was like, why you got an attitude? Like, you got your keys. It could have been worse. And the more he said that, the more my anxiety ran, so the madder I got, and I wouldn't talk to him. So we kind of like, I ain't gonna say we fell out about that, but like we just like, I just stopped talking to him, man. He just stopped talking to me. And of course, I'm a big baby, so I was like all on him later on that night. But yeah, like that just blew me, like blew the fuck out of me. Like I was like so shook. I was so scared. I was like, oh my God, my daddy gonna kill me. I done lost my car in Nashville, and I done lost my keys. I ain't got no spare key. How am I gonna get home? I'm gonna have to tow my car somewhere. Like, it was just like so much stuff running through my head, and it wouldn't stop running even after we found the keys. So after all of that, went home, went to sleep. We woke up the next morning, my best friend left. We went to church, we got breakfast, went to church. We saw Anita Wilson and Rashawn Mitchell. Now, all the gospel heads, y'all know who they are. I was so excited. This church is huge. I took a picture of the church, and I'm going to try to insert the picture somewhere. But I took a picture of the church. It was massive, inside and out. Like, the parking lot is so big. Like, they had people on go-karts, like, taking them to the front of the church. Like, it was so cool. So, from now on, when I go to Murfreesboro or Nashville, that's where I'm going to go. So we leave church, go to Golden Corral. It is just absolutely phenomenal. The food was great, expensive, but great. We leave Golden Corral and we go home and we chill. We order pizza that night, like rabbits. That was my birthday. We came home Monday and I did not want to. That was my birthday weekend. I was so glad. My best friend made my birthday so much better, but my boyfriend made it so much better. And I was just so glad that I got to spend my birthday with them. And if y'all watching this, thank y'all so much, and I love y'all. But anyway, yeah, that was my birthday. I had so much fun. I am so sorry that I did not vlog it like I said I would. I even put it on Twitter. But I'm so sorry that I didn't have a mindset to do it. Didn't want to do it. I wanted to do it, but I didn't do it. I just couldn't make myself do it. So sorry for that. Anyway, like, share, and subscribe. Thank y'all for coming by. Hey to my new subscribers. If you was new to my channel, go ahead. If you have not already, hit the subscribe button. And I don't know why I keep wanting to do my June is Jumping outro. Oh my God. Thank y'all for the birthday wishes. Some of y'all got on Instagram. Not Instagram, but some of y'all got on Snapchat and told me happy birthday. Thank y'all. I really enjoyed my birthday. I am back. I'll be back on somewhat schedule to record. And I'll see y'all bitches in the next video. Bye.
Now when I tell them that it's Barbie, bitch, yes, I really do mean that it's Barbie, bitch. Ask Mattel, they auction my Barbie, bitch. Raggedy Ann could never be a Barbie, bitch. I guess you needed a pack.